as the season moves forward. As in goes Grace, actually getting incredibly aggressive onto Ian.
Wants to get a summoner, doesn't get one, but does get the chunk out onto Ian. Notice
that. Also, Humpty's going to turn up, and you can see no potions available for Ian as well, as another bouncing bob is going to go wide. In goes Beyond, but he actually might be in trouble. Permafrost is going to stun him up, but he does get a really nice stretchy arms. And Umpty, he's in trouble. Going to have to flash out of the way.
Wraith's here as well.
Yeah, not a lot of damage onto these orbs as Wraith's going to turn up. Oh, last second teleport. Not going to be enough. And that's going to be first blood to Jhinair at 3.5 minutes into the game. I just find it interesting that we're seeing the Ziggs at all. Honestly, you're going to see him potentially lose this blue buff, though. Is Permafrost still on there?
Oh, I think we're fighting.
Yeah, Smite's coming down. In goes Beyond. He's going to get the flash. Kidnap comes
Double
down.
Kidnap.
Great position, but it moves him out of all of the damage. And Emperor's Divide's doing massive work. Jhinair should be able to clean this one up. Even Sohan is going to survive.
And the kidnap happening, and it's just a disaster for MVP. If you watch this, it looks like the start of a perfect team fight,
but the circles
that you alluded to don't line up at all, and they get crunched by the Azir damage. Grace is free hitting on the backside. Sohan and Meganar going to be tanky enough to survive through all of it. A bad look. It's always interesting and dependent on builds from the Gnar. Gnar has the choice to build for lane or not. You know, Beyond is sauntering around bot side.
Well, speaking of Beyond, does come in once again, but we do have the rocket jump. Teddy's going to be A-OK. Topside, a bit of aggression as that kidnap ain't doing all that much. As Max, oh, he's just going to eat him. Spits him back out. And Beyond, it was almost like he was celebrating by turning into goo on the ground.
Pick the wrong fight against either a Ziggs or a Zir, you know what happens.
Well, Beyond is looking for this Birdman in the mid lane. Does get the kidnap off. Jumps him over his wall. Gets the flash, which is exactly what they needed. And the heal. But ADD, he's getting solid on topside. Orange is coming at the right time. Good flash. As someone's chasing after him. Is it going to be enough? Mega Invulnerable? No, he's too quick. Thanks to the extra 5% move speed on the Ancient Coin.
Doesn't really have an escape route, and he's dead. Dunked by Ian.
Blue buff, they're looking for their first one of the game to be delivered over to Ian.
They don't have any vision on Grace. He's coming in, but they're coming into this.
Yeah, in goes Beyond. He's trying to get what he can, but no kidnaps available. Emperor's Divide going to get rid of ADD and Ian on the other side of this battle. In comes the Abyssal Voyage as MVP's bottom lane turn up. Mega Inferno Bomb onto Grace, who takes so much damage. Double kill for Ian. As now MVP looking to try and get out. Beyond's not going to be able to. They're happy to get a couple of kills on the mid laner.
3 for 3. Should have been working towards a Leandris' second iron. That's interesting. Watching the replay here, we saw what was happening on the top side. Notice what happens when the Tristana groups. I think Umpty did pick up the blue there. It was hard to tell. The 1 for 1, though, meant that things started very, very even. Awkward part is Abyssal Voyage gets pilot there. He's almost instantly burst out, but you notice he's actually ulted over the wall. The Satchel Charge doesn't kill him and ends up going 2 for 2 in the air.
Yeah.
The ramping damage doesn't necessarily synergize as well as Beyond looking for this.
Yeah, Dazzle does go wide as Beyond does come in. Not going to use the Q just yet as the Devour in at exactly the right time. Permafrost will be there as Pilot gets himself out, but Baron's been started once again.
And
Teddy over the side. He drew a bead and he smacked down the Purple Worm. Wraith now in trouble. Hasn't used the ultimate just yet as he's going to be able to get the connection. No, he gets stunned out of it. The passive is still going to be there, but Max, he's in trouble in the front line. Flashes away. That's a very last minute cannon barrage.
Once built for lane, he's going to play the Ruin King. As next time, already has a Phantom Dancer, but he's going to be pinched.
Yeah, he is. It's going to be Pilot delivered into this one. Flash comes in, but that was a little bit of an optimistic move from Jhinair, but this turret will go down. Thankfully, it won't. And God, Teddy does some damage.
Spawning. We're 35 minutes in, so it's super powered, and MVP are in no position to face Jhinair.
Well, that's going to be what Beyond is doing, and he's going to have to try and kidnap his way out, but he's not going to be able to. The Bloblets don't last long at all as the Sand Soldiers deal with them.
Evaporates.
Whatever globals are used, picking up a single kill is not enough.
To be pulled out of vision, you need to try and get in there, try and get Beyond to steal something, but True Shot Barrage ain't going to do nothing. Wave clear, just not quite enough. 26 seconds on the Baron should be easily enough as Ian has to flash out of the way. Everyone flashing to escape the damage, but look at that! Sand Soldiers tearing them apart. It's no pentakill for Teddy, but it's definitely a game win as Jin Air continue their destruction from their victory 2-0 against Kongdu, and now game one against MVP.
You're going 3-0 on patch 8.4, and even though MVP, we questioned their draft, no questions about Jin Air's draft. It is very patch 8.4. They executed it well. There were concerns around 25 minutes where they couldn't advance their position. But credit to Jin Air. They look for the second Baron Snake, and it seems so obvious when you try to sneak it one time, never go to it again. The second time MVP did not respect it fast enough. The Azir and the Tristana trained it down, and then the game was out of MVP's hands. They were watching as Jin Air took every objective on the map. While their KDAs didn't suffer too much after that, the game ending seemed like a formality.
Yeah, I want to look at MVP really adjust the draft in game number two, because it was cute. We understood the ideas. We were excited to see whether it could work, but honestly, it just straight up didn't. I think they need to go back to something that's tried and true and try and have some winning lanes, have some capabilities as far as executing in the earlier stages and not just fall over and die, which is basically what they did here this game.
Some of the sounds in this replay were far too loud. Six Love was yeah. Hilariously loud. They continued to poke in. By the time they even thought about fighting, I mean, the base was already basically dead. And I was watching Teddy. I missed Grace. Just instant kill everyone. Flash forward. There's the command attack. Goodbye, everybody.
Just even so you know, Q was nerfed on Azir.
In the early game, it was...